Hello everyone, this is my first video on this channel. The goal of this channel is to stay on shape in any kind of technologies like coding, scripting, and in DevOps methodologies and any kind of technology that involves computing. And the main goal I do this because this is a really tough time in our world right now, and many people in quarantine and a lot of people lost their jobs, so I bet that a lot of people is going to want to stay in shape in any kind of skill sets that they want to remaster at their work or just for fun. So I decided to create a channel and focus on Python programming or anything of any scripting or programming language that we know, and just share my knowledge with you so I get to teach and you get to learn from my coding skills, and this is really great in these tough times. So the first videos that I'm going to create is actually going to focus, as I said, in Python programming. And what I'm going to do is collect any kind of challenges from any kind of sites that involves Python, and I'm going to share my resolving methods of any of these challenges. Obviously, because there is more than one way to resolve any kind of problem when it comes to programming, and this is what I want to do so you will really develop your creativity skills when you program. So I found a site that's called edabit.com, where you just simply can go and search up for challenges from any level, from beginning to expert. And I want to solve now a easy challenge that's called find the missing number. So what this wants to do is just to write a function that returns the missing number among just some list of numbers. So let's see how we can do that. Okay, so obviously I want to write a function that's called def missing number, and it's going to get a missing list, and I want to execute that by this way. Missing list is equals to, let's say, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, you know what, 7 and 9. So obviously what I want this function to do is to return 8. This should return 8. Okay, so let's see how we can do that. Obviously, I want to have a list of all numbers between 0 to 9. So I can do this with the range function. Let's call the parameter here numbers list. List range 0 to 10. So this line of code is going to return all numbers between 0 to 9, including 9 and 0. And how I can figure out what number is missing here? So I can loop through each number on this list by that way, and I can check if the num is not inside the missing list that is given here in this function. Then stop, print me the number. Missing number is num, and obviously return it, so the execution of the for loop will stop. So let's see what I get back when I execute this line of code. Okay, I get missing number is 8, but this solution is not the best I could do. Let's say that I remove also the number 2 from here. So now this should return 8 and 2. Let's see what happens now. If I execute that, this is going to stop and return only 2. And why this is happening? Because I told him to return the first number that is missing among the list of numbers from 0 to 9. So it's not going to search up for next numbers because the function saw that 2 is missing, so it will stop there because of the return. So how I can make this function more efficient? Let's see. So obviously we want to return missing numbers now, and I will change the function name, and I will delete all what I did here, and we will look for more efficient way to do this. So there is a method called set.difference that is going to accept two arguments. The first argument, this is actually a set of numbers, and the second is set of numbers, but the second one is going to be the missing, so it can search for the missing numbers. So we will put a comma here because we want to pass two arguments, and the first one will be numbers list. You know this line, we just wrote it a minute ago. List of numbers between 0 to 10, and I'm going to pass this one as first and the second one as this one. But something is not polite here. Well, we call the method set and we asked for the difference, so obviously the numbers list is list. So this is not the best type to pass here in this one, and this is also writes me expected type set got list instead. So what I can do in this case is convert it to set, and I'm going to do this with the both, and now I can print the calculation here and let's see what it returns. Great, so now we returned also 8 and 2 because of a more advanced function to look in missing numbers between two lists that converted to set. Okay, so this is my first video that we just completed. Hope this video has helped you. And the set.difference method is actually very useful, and you can use it anywhere where you have to calculate some missing numbers or missing strings or anything. And that's it. Have a nice day and see you in the next one.